Good morning, everyone, or it might be the evening by the time I upload this, but it is the morning now. It's just 9 a.m. Friday, 3 weeks out today from the first show, MK Classic, and we are up at AKA HQ to get an in-person session and check in with Alan. I've been doing these for the last 3 or 4 weeks, so every Friday I'll come up, instead of like an online check-in, I'll come up in person, put on the board shorts, go through some posing, and just be able to see the physique in person. So I'm going to bring you through that today. Probably won't do a huge amount of, you know, talking. I don't want to hold up the session. The session's normally about an hour long. Quite quick, quite intense, but I feel like I look my best after these sessions because it's not dragged out for an hour and a half and start to fade towards the end. So I tend to look quite good at the end of the session. So I'm just going to let the camera roll, pick up some clips. I might talk over it, edit it when I get home, might just leave it roll, and of course record the posing and anything kind of Alan has to say about that. I find these in-person check-ins to be, you know, invaluable to me. It was one of the reasons why when I came back that I did want to sign up with Alan. I knew obviously he was, you know, based in Ireland, that he'd done in-person check-ins, and for me to be able to come up and have my physique critiqued in person and just be able to see what we're looking like and make adjustments off that, like I said, is invaluable. And I always leave here feeling very motivated, whether it's okay, we have more work to do, or we're right on track. Every time it's been right on track, it's never been you look like a piece of shit, so it's always good. We're always leaving here on a good buzz. But yeah, really find these in-person check-ins help a lot, and just put your mind at ease, know you're exactly where you need to be. You're not just sending over photos in perfect lighting with a pump and, you know, making someone think you look better than what you actually are. You're seeing it for what it is in person, and getting, you know, live feedback from that. And of course, with the pose as well, Alan is very kind of men's physique focused, which was another reason why I wanted to sign up, is I knew he had a lot of men's physique athletes, worked with a lot of them, always gets them in really good condition. And like I said in my last video, the posing, he had changed up my front pose, which is something I wasn't really confident in. I thought like my delts weren't the best, chest wasn't the best, and, you know, just small little things. I wasn't really confident holding the pose, and even getting into it, I found it hard getting into the pose consistently without having to look myself in the mirror and make 10 adjustments. Whereas, you know, we made a small adjustment in person. Again, that's why it's so invaluable. And now it's probably one of my strongest shots and made my waist look tiny. Abs and obliques are popping a lot more. And delts, arms, everything, just the taper is just perfect for men's physique. So yeah, just another reason why, you know, it was a good idea for me to sign up and have these in-person check-ins. So I'm going to go in now, get warmed up, take a piss, because we were driving only about an hour, but drinking a lot of water. And when you're very lean, you have to piss quite frequently. So we're going to get set up and then I will bring you through the session.
Yep.
Are you trying to hit failure here with these, or are you just getting warm?
Push it.
Okay. Just do one here, two.
Yeah, two or three reps.
Oh yeah, that's good.
Slow everything down, yeah. Yeah.
Okay, that feels good. That feels good.
We worked on two,
but we had done four plates on the flat. All right, let's go now. 6 to 10. Let's get it. Good. Yes, Alan. Come on now. Yes. Good. That's it. Drive through. Yes. And again, yes. Keep going now, more there. Drive through those handles. Press, you, come on. Right, will I work with 2.5?
Yeah.
Okay, let's work. Oh, yeah, let's work. Let's go.
Beautiful. Beautiful. There you go, I'll put that.
Oh, take it. Take it. Yeah, feels good. I think last time we had the neutral grip pressing out, that feels all right. Watch out. Yep. Yes. Good.
Yep.
Yes. Yep. That's the one. Yep.
Yep.
Good, Alan. Yep.
Yep.
Easy. Yep. Yes. Still moving now, come on. Drive, yes. Yes, and again, and again.
No, you, you.
Yep. Good.
Yep.
Good. Come on. Come on. Yes. Good, Alan. Come on. Keep it moving. Keep it moving. Come on. Come on. There you go. Nice. Right. Yep.
Control. Yep. Two. Three. Four, good. Five, good. Six. Seven. Let's go. Leave it there.
See the way, like, it started off so fresh, it's moving, and it's just like the energy just like is zapped like that. Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay, what is up everyone? We are back from the AKA HQ and what a session that was. Holy shit, I'm after leaving that just so excited, buzzed, but really calm and relaxed now at the same time. Basically, the feedback was that we're ready. We could jump on stage this weekend if we wanted to. Feedback is we're 98% there. We're having a refeed tomorrow, which I'm absolutely buzzing. So I'm actually going to extend this video the refeed tomorrow, throw that in. So it might be a little bit of a longer video, throw a bit more content in there and show you what goes into a refeed. It's pretty much just going to be all the same stuff that I would normally have, but just more of it. So more oats, more potatoes, more rice, and more bagels. I get to have 5 bagel tins. It's actually 3 bagels is on it, but because we buy bagel tins, that's what's on the plan. 5 of those equates to 3 regular bagels. So you will see me munching on 5 bagels tomorrow. But yeah, feedback was that we're ready pretty much. We're going to feed up tomorrow. Not sure what will happen the next week or the week after, but we could feed up into the show. I know for the load, he was saying we're going to front load the week of the show. So I'm competing on Saturday. So I think Tuesday, Wednesday, carb load. Thursday, Friday could be back to like baseline food. And then on the day, it's just meals and water and assess as we go. So yeah, very, very excited. Feedback was really good. He's very, very happy with where we are. Said fat loss wise, you know, we're there. There's no more to come off. So that is pretty much it. So I'll be excited to see after the refeed what happens, because normally when I refeed, I go up about 0.5 kilo. Last time it was like 0.6 kg. The day after the refeed, I'll come back down normally to where I was. And then the day after, so 2 days after the refeed, I'll get a big drop down and condition just seems to improve. So, man, I'm so fucking excited. So I'm just going to do my 35 minutes cardio now. We had our 45 minutes done this morning. Go up and train Allen's and I come home and I just do my 35 minutes post-workout here on the bike. Man, look at my face. It is scalded. I just look back at some of the clips from I recorded before I started. And yeah, you can see, man, my forehead and nose is scalded. Body is a nice tan, but forehead absolutely got it. Also, what are we thinking of the trim? Do we fucks with it? This is going to be the show day haircut. So it's like a little bit of a V. Also, this kind of quiff, we're going to keep it up and keep it tidy in the front and a little bit messy, a little party in the back. So let me know if you fucks with the haircut. I fucks with it. I really like it. I wanted a little bit of a change up from just a regular fade. I think the V works quite well. So yeah, that is it. I'm going to do my cardio now. I think I'll leave this here for today and we'll pick back up tomorrow when we are on a refeed. I'm going to be training pull tomorrow, but I already recorded that on my last one. So I'll just show you the meals tomorrow and show you what goes into a refeed and maybe the science behind it and all that. So I will catch you then. Okay, good morning again everyone. So it is the next day, Saturday the 12th of August, and today we are exactly 21 days out. So exactly 3 weeks out. I know I said yesterday I was 3 weeks out, but it was 3 weeks, 1 day. The first show was on a Saturday. So today we are 21 days out. We are 3 weeks out. So today is the day of the refeed. I'm going to do my fasted weigh-in now, see what we're looking like. I believe it's going to be a new low weigh-in. So I'm just going to hop on the scales now and see what we're cooking with. Okay, so it is indeed a low weigh-in. Have a look at this.
So we are 75 bang on. Okay, so that is 0.5 of a kg dropped off yesterday. Brand new low weighing, exactly what I want. Coming into a refeed, perfect to fill up. Body like a sponge, ready to absorb all the carbs. So I'm going to run through what my refeed is. Right now, it is 7:15 in the morning. So I still just have to do my fasted cardio. And then I can eat my big bowl of oats. So let's just see what we're working with the refeed. Okay, so for the refeed, we are on 3,832 calories, 229 grams of protein, 657 grams of carbs, 32 grams of fat. So protein is a tiny bit lower, it's only 20 grams lower, so only a small bit lower than what it normally would. You normally lower protein just to make sure that digestion is going to be in a better place. Protein is the hardest macronutrient to actually break down, so that's why you lower it a little bit when you carb up. So 229 grams of protein. Carbs is on 650, so just over twice the amount we would normally have on a training day. I think it's actually the exact... No, yeah, it's a little bit over double, about 2.5 times what I'd normally have on a regular training day. So looking forward to that. And then fats are a little bit lower, as we want to make sure the majority of the calories are coming from carbs and they're, you know, biased towards the carbs. So that is what we are doing today. So like I said, just going to do my fasted cardio now, get that done, shower, and then we will check back in for meal one.
Okay, so we are done cardio now, we are showered, and we're about to have our first meal. So for the first meal, it's going to be pre-workout. We are having 150 grams of oats. We have 100 grams of mixed frozen berries, but unfortunately there's not a raspberry to be had in the town, so I'm just going to use the carbs that was for the raspberries and replace it with banana. We also have 100 grams of banana in there as well as 30 grams of whey protein. So mine is going to be 150 grams of oats, 150 grams of banana, and 30 grams of the caramel biscuit whey protein mixed in. So I'll show you when it's done. Pro tip with your oats, so with this I done 150 grams of oats, so I done 3.5 times the amount of water, as it's a lot of volume. Cover it up, use a plate, fucking tea towel, something, and actually like leave it steam, and you can see there it's already starting to soak up quite well. And then once that is all soaked up, we are going to add in our whey protein. So I will catch you when the full vessel is finished.
Oh Jesus.
Okay, and there we have it, the first meal. Look at the size of this thing. Get a little thumbnail. Size of that. Nice. Okay, I am going to devour this and then we are going to go train. Also, don't forget salt with every meal. So I have 2 grams of pink salt on every meal. Help yourself get a little pump. So let's dig in. Okay, we're just about ready to go to the gym now. So I'm gonna make up my intra shake. This isn't included in my meal plan or in the refeed. It's like in the list of supplements. It's just 20 grams of cyclic dextrin. So it's not actually included in the total amount of calories, but it's a consistent thing that's in there every day on a training day. So shaker at the ready. This is the cyclic dextrin, the carbs that I use. So it's from NXT GlycoPower. I like this one because you have electrolytes in it as well, so it saves me getting cyclic dextrin and electrolytes. It's all in one. This is the unflavored one because I did have the blue raspberry and it was pungent, and it was just sickening, artificial tasting. So I was like, right, I'll get the unflavored one and, you know, I'll mix something through it. And still with the unflavored one, it's kind of like sour or bitter. It's weird. It doesn't taste like sweet cyclic dextrin. So I just put 20 grams of that in. And I just literally just mix in, like dilute. I do have a pineapple flavor of this on the way, as this is nearly done now. So I'm hoping the pineapple might be a little bit sweeter. I feel like blue raspberry is like an artificial taste, isn't it? Maybe pineapple will be a little bit sweeter and a bit more natural. And then we have creatine going in, and 2 grams of pink salt for a little pump. So that is it. We're gonna make this up, go train,
and I will check back in when it is after the gym and it is post-workout. I might put up some clips of posing after the session, just see what the pump is like with a bit of carbs in, but I'm not going to bring the camera in. I'm just going to bring my phone in, so I might just throw up a few clips there before we transition into the post-workout meal. So catch you then.
Okay, we are back from the gym. Session is done. Quite a good session, actually. Didn't feel energy dipping off, which isn't surprising considering, you know, I had a good feed of carbs before going in. Posing went very well. I'll put up a picture there. So that's what I looked like after the session. Quite happy with the look, the shape. Bit more fullness in the delts and arms. Midsection, maybe not as tight, but there was a lot of volume in the stomach before the session. So very, very happy with the overall look. We are now back for post-workout. Very similar to the pre-workout meal, but it is 200 grams of oats and then just 50 grams of banana. It is supposed to be 100 grams of the frozen raspberries, but because we can't get them at the moment, which is really fucking annoying, we're just going to do the 50 grams of banana and then obviously 30 grams of whey protein mixed in. So I'm just going to leave this soak up now, show you what it looks like. So that is 200 grams of oats. And we went with a 3.5 water ratio. So we have 700 mils of water in there. No need to do a 4-to-1 or a 5-to-1 ratio and push it, as there's already so much volume in it. I actually think this is going to be quite hard to get down and to finish it all, but these refeeds don't come along very often. So we're going to make sure that we finish every last little scrap of it. So I'll check back in for the next. Okay, and finished product, exact same as earlier, only a little less banana and a lot more oats. You can see it there, have the little caramel syrup going on, salt on top. Maybe this will be the thumbnail. Whoa, so much oats. Whoa. Okay, I'm gonna shut up, stop being a fool, and eat this. We are watching the Premier League, because it's back. The stream is frozen at the moment. But yeah, that is what we were doing. So we are going to watch this, finish this meal, and then we have some work to do today. I have some new setups to do, sending out some plans to Australia, mate. So yeah, going to finish this, do all that, and check in for meal three. Okay, and this is basically what we are working with for meal three. So we have 5 bagel pins. These ones in the air fryer, done the other ones in the toaster, so took a while. On them, you have sriracha and a little bit of Lion Light mayo. So very low calorie sauces, a little bit on those, and obviously it's going to go on those as well. And then we have 2 whole eggs, 150 ml of egg white, and then there's just some spring onion and seasoning and the sriracha sauce on that as well. So big, big feed. Very excited to get into this. One thing about eating 5 bagels is you get an insane jaw pump. By the time I get onto the 3rd bagel thin, it fucking just pumps the shit out of my jaw. On the plan, it says 3 regular bagels. I think I said this morning, but just in case, it says 3 regular bagels, but because bagel thins are what are on my regular plan, I don't have regular bagels in the house, just bagel thins. So 5 bagel thins equates to the same amount of calories and carbs as 3 regular size bagels, just in case you are wondering. But yes, I'm going to talk into this. I am very hungry, got my work done. It was about 3 hours since the last meal, so very hungry for this right now, and I cannot wait to get this down. Okay, so while we wait for meal 4 to cook, currently in the dual ninja air fryer at the moment, I'll show you when it's done and go through it, but while we wait for that to cook, I thought I'd just break down, you know, what is a refeed, you know, what's the goal, what are you trying to achieve with it? So a refeed is literally just feeding your body more food, normally in the form of carbs. I don't think it's ever really any other way. You're just taking in more carbohydrates than what you have been previously. So for example, on prep at the moment, I'm on around roughly, I think it's 250 or 270 carbs on a training day. So quite low for, you know, what I'm doing, the activity I'm doing, the training I'm doing. On the refeed day to day, we are on just over 650 grams of carbs. So I think that's like 2.5 times, maybe over 2.5 times the amount that I would normally take in. So why do we do this? There's a few reasons why you might do it. One could be to slow down the rate of loss. So if you're losing weight too quickly, you can utilize a refeed to kind of slow that down. So that's probably one of the reasons why I'm using it now. I'm at the back end of prep. I'm only 3 weeks away. I'm still losing, you know, over a kilo a week, which I don't really need to at this stage. You know, most of the body fat, if not all, is off that I'm going to have off for stage. So just to slow down that rate of loss, we're utilizing a refeed. So by tomorrow, my weight will come up a little bit and then it will slowly start to bring itself back down. By the time it comes back down next week, it will still be under what it was before the refeed, but obviously just not as drastically, because the refeed is kind of like a pit stop, nearly, like, kind of, you know, kills momentum, but then it starts, picks back up again. Second reason, if your training performance takes a hit. Now, this doesn't mean that, you know, you go down on one lift and it's, oh, I need a refeed, I need more food. It's not like that. But again, tail end of prep or a dieting phase, and, you know, his training performance just isn't there. You know, your pumps aren't there. Your energy within the gym and kind of mindset towards the sessions starts to go. A refeed might be a good idea to bring up the energy within the session, get more out of it, and just be able to take some form of progressions again. Now, again, you need to be objective about this, and this is why it's so important to have a coach. You could go in, have one poor session, and all of a sudden, I need to give myself a refeed, you know, give myself a refeed. Whereas a coach will know when to utilize a refeed and when not to. And then a third reason could be if you actually stop losing weight. So you will get to a certain point again in prep or in a dieting phase where you are digging really, really hard. You're running on absolute empty, you're running on fumes, and it feels like your body is nearly working against you. You're putting it under so much stress, so much work, that it nearly starts fighting back against you, where it's maybe not losing as much as it should be for the activity you're doing, the cardio you are doing. And more than likely, it's because your body just isn't fresh, it's drained, it's stressed. So it's not losing the amount it should be. Again, utilizing a refeed here to get your body working with you again, rather than against you. And this is why, again, so important to have a coach. You could just, you know, you could panic for 1 week, maybe not see the rate, maybe you're looking to lose a kilo a week, you might not see that 1 week. And again, if you're not objective, you might say, give myself a refeed. And then, you know, it might not be warranted, it might not be needed. For me, I know if I didn't have a coach, I would not know when to utilize a refeed properly. There's been plenty of times when I've been low on energy, training performance has been down, stressed, body not feeling fresh, feeling tired, and I didn't get a refeed for weeks. If it was me coaching myself, I'd think straight away, I'd panic, I need a refeed. You know, I'm losing muscle, I'm losing training performance, you know, numbers are down, things like that. If I didn't have a coach, I would completely fuck it up. And that's why it's so important to have someone, you know, with a second eye, you know, a bird's eye view, just being objective. You're emotionally attached to yourself and your own kind of body progress, dieting phase. With a coach, it's just business. It's nothing personal, it's just business. So that's why it is so important to do. A fourth or another reason why you might utilize refeed, or well, why you do utilize refeed, is to collect data for peak week, for prep. So this is kind of specifically for prep, maybe for photo shoots as well, do a little peak, but it's to see how your body reacts when you top it up with carbs. So maybe you utilize a refeed and you push too many carbs and you realize, okay, that's, you know, a softer look. And then 2 days after, you know, it's perfect. Then you will know you have collected that data and you just repeat that process when it comes to peak week for, you know, your bodybuilding show. You might do a two-day refeed, you know, higher carbs, and think you're still flat. You know, you're not even touching the sides here. You're not looking full. So you know to then kind of push more things. And again, I could not do this up myself. This is the one thing that I know I would not be able to do myself. I could prep myself, I could get myself in very good condition, but when it comes to, you know, peak weeks, refeeds, you know, just being objective with these things, I know I couldn't do it myself, and that's where I really need someone, you know, looking over me to do it. So you're also collecting data for peak week. So when we run into this peak week now, which is only going to be 2 weeks away at this stage, we're just going to be repeating everything we have been done here, doing so far. There's no guesswork. I'm just going to repeat what I've already done. We know it works. We know I fill out. I don't think I need a massive amount of food to fill out, to be honest. I think if I was to do like 1,000 grams of carbs over 2 days, I think I'd get pretty soft, to be honest. I think I hold the food quite a bit. Whereas when we do the 1 day at 650 carbs, I think I look pretty decent the next day. I don't get really, you know, soft or watery. If anything, it's that bit fuller.
and it's like the muscle is popping a bit more, which is exactly what you want. You run flat, and then when you top up and fill up, it's supposed to, you know, push the muscle against the skin. All the glycogen is being replenished, and it's pushing against the skin to give it that, you know, pop and vascularity. So those are the reasons why you would utilize a refeed. So that's basically the whole, everything surrounding a refeed. So if training performance is down, general energy, mood is down, losing weight too fast, maybe not losing weight at all and you haven't been for a while, refeed is just to freshen up the body to get ready to go again. When I've been doing refeeds, it's literally just been one day and then it's straight back to it. It's not, you know, 2 or 3 day thing. And it's also the same foods that I have been eating. It's nothing different. I'm not going out and getting, you know, a burger and fries or anything off plan. It's exactly what has been on my plan. Look back at my previous video. I think it was literally the one before this. See all the foods I was eating. What I'm eating now is the exact same, just more of it. So more rice, more potatoes, more bagels, more oats. That is it. So that is a refeed. I think my food is nearly done. 3 minutes to go. I will show you meal four when it is ready.
Wait until you see this absolute monstrous bowl. Oh my God. Oh, okay. So we have 600 grams of potatoes all cut up. That is our base here. You can see that. Seasoned with salt, pepper, sudden fried seasoning. 20 minutes in the air fryer. Done all cubed up. We have 120 grams of chicken, so less protein just to help with digestion, and it has the southern fried seasoning on it. Go back to my last video, you will see that. A little bit of spring onion, a little bit of red pepper for my veg, and then sriracha sauce, lighter and light mayo, and just salt and pepper on top, and just feast your eyes on that. Oh my God. I'm very excited to eat this. Okay, let's tuck in. Let's give it a taste test. I feel like I need to show myself eating the food, or else I could just be making this, throwing it in the bin, and then going off and getting takeaway. You'd never know. So yeah, we're going to at least take a bite of this one, I suppose. Chewing when you have the road mouth is one of the most disgusting things ever, especially when you swallow. You hear that? Because it's right up against your fucking throat. That is delicious, by the way, right? I'm going to polish this off, and I'll just show you the bowl when it's polished off.
Path of cash, and he thinks he's got an open goal. And he cannot believe he's
missed. Oh, yeah. Oh, sweating after that. Look how fucking disgusting it looks, man. Look at that milk. Sriracha on the corners. Sweaty forehead. That's how you know it was a good meal. Anyway, polished it off. Oh, just so you know, I am eating these big, massive bowls of food. And I could eat another one of them, man. When I made it, I was like, that's a big bowl of food. Like, potatoes are very, very filling. A little bit of veg in there. There was a lot going on. Thought I was going to fill me a lot more than it did. I'm hungry. It is just gone past 7. It's 7:05 now. And we have one more meal to get in, which is just going to be chicken and rice. So same as that, but instead of potatoes, same amount of carbs in rice form. So 150 grams of carbs. So I'm going to wash out that bowl. Make up the next one in 2 hours, so at about 9 we'll have it, and show you that, and then we can finally close out this video. It feels like this video's gone on a while, because I started recording yesterday morning. I'm going to finish tonight, but I think it'll be a good one. So catch you for meal 5. And here we are, meal 5, last meal of the day. Sorry about the lighting, it is getting a little bit dark. It's 9 o'clock now, and look at this for a whopper of a meal. So very similar to the last meal, the only difference is the carb source. We are doing rice rather than potatoes. So 150 grams of rice, 120 grams of chicken. I actually put lettuce in this one because I thought I was going to be much fuller from the potato meal, and I wasn't, and I know I'll digest and get through the rice even easier than the potatoes. So a little bit of lettuce in here, red onion, scallions or spring onions, whatever you want to call them, lard and light mayo, sriracha, and a load of salt on the top. So this is the last meal. We are going to leave the video here. I hope you enjoyed everything. Hope you enjoyed the push session with Alan, the in-person check-in, a little bit of behind the scenes with the posing. And then enjoyed me eating a load of fucking food. But tomorrow
It is back to the grind, back to the dig, back to 2,400 calories tomorrow. I think I have about 220 carbs on a rest day, 60 minutes cardio in the morning, and then we just chill for today. I am going to finish this and then play some Pokemon and go to bed. Like I said in the last video, have other things to do besides just being a bodybuilder and prep, and things will go a lot smoother and a lot easier. And this is why prep is so fucking easy for me. This is a small portion of what I do with myself. It's just eating meals, going to the gym, doing cardio, and then there's all this other stuff outside of it that makes everything else just so much easier. My life isn't just prep bodybuilding, which maybe some people like, but for me just makes this so much more stress-free. It's just eating meals, doing cardio and training, you know, stop fucking being so dramatic about it. It's grand, like, it's absolutely grand. So we'll leave this here. I will catch you in the next video. I don't know what it is going to be, but by the time the next video is out, we will only be 2 weeks out, I'm assuming. By then, we'll get one out by next week. If you did enjoy this video, as always, make sure to like, comment, and subscribe. And I will catch you in the next one.